Well guys, I'm finally back. If you didn't know, I was gone for the last week since my PC's graphics card was completely fucked. For that reason, I wasn't able to upload a proper video in this Thursday. Finally, I'm back in business, baby, so expect big things from me. First of all, I wanted to review Monster Musume, since next Thursday I will be uploading a video where I talk about all of the latest news regarding the second season. Before I review this anime though, I want to get some announcements out of the way. As we say in every single video without fail, anime news will be coming soon enough. For new viewers or people that don't know what it is, anime news is a live stream where me and Marcus, my colleague, talk about the latest news in the anime industry. Talking about new things happening in animes, for example, what's happening in My Hero Academia. Even though that's more on the manga related side, but we will obviously talk about mangas as well. And talking about series and new seasons coming out. Other than that, this week there should be a double video on Saturday. We have recorded it about 1 to 2 weeks ago, but since I had a problem with my laptop, I wasn't able to edit it any earlier. So, today I will be talking about Monster Musume, as I already said. So, if you don't know this anime, it's heavily based on the ecchi genre. So, if you don't really like that type of genre or those types of animes, I suggest clicking off. But if you are interested still, Monster Musume has one season for now, or maybe forever, unfortunately, with 12 episodes. It also has two OVAs and one special episode where we get to see what happens in their day-to-day lives. It isn't, though, only a ecchi anime, since I would find that quite boring. In fact, it's a fantasy harem anime where we see girls with anime-like or animal-like features, for example, tails, ears, wings, and etc. Regarding the story of the anime or the first episode, it starts with the interaction between the main character, Kurusu, and Mia. Kurusu will be the main character for the entire anime because he is playing or plays an important role to a lot of the characters that we will be seeing. So in this interaction, Mia, which is a demi-human, which is basically another race of humans or maybe even another species that have animal characteristics. She is a spot snake since her lower body is one of a snake. They are living together thanks to the demi-human exchange program, which is similar to our student exchange program, if that makes sense, where we see them and humans living together. In Mia and Kurusu's case, they started living together after they have a moment where she discovers that he accepts her as just a girl, without looking at her snake side. This is what ultimately makes her fall in love with him, which is what carries the plot and gives birth to the harem side of this anime. As the anime progresses, we see more and more girls falling for him, ultimately taking refuge in his humble abodes. So, what do I think about this anime? Well, personally, I like ecchi / harem animes, even though they're not my favorites. But as most guys do, I do like this genre. But apart from that shallow opinion, I think this anime, even if it didn't have the ecchi side of it, it would still be entertaining since we do get to see how it's like to live with beings or just species different but also very similar to us, which is something I don't think we'll live through anytime soon. Plus, in this anime, we get to see a lot of different types of demi-humans, which becomes quite interesting at times. Since there's, well, as I said, a part snake, part human girl, there's a part horse, part human girl, there's a harpy, which is basically a girl which has, well, bird-like features. She has wings for her arms and just claws as her legs. We also see a mermaid, so yeah, there's a lot of variations. And that does make it very interesting, because we get to see a lot of different characters. But apart from that positive part, This anime can be quite boring at times, because after a bit we get to see every character, and since it doesn't have any fighting to it, and or other types of entertainment values, I don't think it's that entertaining at times. Obviously, there's a lot of times where it is, but when it isn't, the creators obviously use the ecchi part of it to make it interesting, since it's quite graphic. By that I mean that there's an uncensored version, which is obviously what everyone looks at, and we get to see everything. That's why they choose to include that in parts where there isn't very much to be entertained by, I guess I could say. So I guess I can give them props for that, but I mean, it doesn't take too much skill to do that kind of stuff. But yeah, that's what I think is the negative part, if you could say, of this anime. It did remind me a bit of High School DxD. If you don't know what it is, it's basically a anime where we see... Well, I don't know how to describe it well, because it was a long time when I saw this anime, but it talks about demons or devils and angels, fallen angels, and there's a lot of fighting to it, but there's also a ecchi side to it. But that anime, I personally think, is better because it has the fighting to it and it makes it much more entertaining. But the only reason why it reminds me of it is because it has an ecchi side as well. Apart from that, another thing that I do like, instead of not like, in this anime is the OVAs, because we get to see them trying to train, because obviously they need to train and lose some weight, because they can't just be lazy all the time. So this is actually quite interesting, because we get to see the gyms that, well, actually there's a costume gym, obviously, because, you know, some, like the snake girl, which has a tail, which is at least... I don't know, 5 to 10 meters long, or the mermaid girl, they can't really use normal equipment, for example weightlifting, so they have to do costume stuff. Obviously in the mermaid side, you just need to, you know, make her swim and then she'll be fit all the time, because if you don't know, swimming is something that takes a lot of effort, and if you look at guys or girls that swim, or professionally swim, they are fit as fuck, so I think that's gonna be enough training for her. Anyway, those OVAs are actually quite entertaining, so I suggest going to watch them. So that's all I want to say about this anime, positives and negatives. So I suggest you go give it a watch, since I still think it can be entertaining, and if you like ecchi or harem animes, you'll definitely enjoy this one, I'll tell you that much. So yeah, I still think this anime is quite decent, even though sometimes it can be boring. But I am waiting for the second season, even though the anime came out in like 2015 or something, and the second season hasn't yet come out. But I mean, in One Punch Man case, it took a long time to get that. And maybe even going to Incredible, if you don't know what Incredibles is, it's just an old animated movie. It took like 10 years, I think, if not even more, to get the second movie. So I guess there is always hope. Anyway, that's all I want to say. I hope to see you in the next video, where hopefully it will be anime news. It will probably be the second or the double video, but still at least content, am I right? But yeah, subscribe if you like this video, and like, comment to give your opinion. If you didn't like this video, then well, we take any criticism. It really helps us to you know, get better, because if you just look at the video and just say no, I don't like this, and click off, then we don't know what you didn't like about this video, and we can't really improve. So that really helps us, and we appreciate that. In any case, that's all I want to say. Thank you for tuning into Anime Radio, and I hope to see you in the next one. Goodbye.